In this video, we are going to visualize the working of bubble sort algorithm. So first, we will go through the idea behind the bubble sort algorithm using a simulation. And then we will have a look at the animated version of how this sorting algorithm works. And finally, we will implement this bubble sort algorithm in Python. Bubble sort is a very simple method that sorts the array element by repeatedly moving the largest element to the highest index position of the array segment in case of arranging elements in ascending order. In bubble sorting, consecutive adjacent pair of elements in the array are compared with each other, and if the element at the lower index is greater than the element at the higher index, then we swap the values so that the element is placed before the bigger one. And this process will continue till the list of the unsorted element exhausts. So, according to the definition of the bubble sort, the most important part of the algorithm is to compare two adjacent elements of the array, and if the element at the current index is greater than the element at the next index, then we need to swap it. And we need to do this for the entire array and for each pass. So we need two for loops. Outer loop will take care of each passes, and since after each pass the largest element of the array is placed at the very last index, so we need to decrease the range of inner loop by subtracting I, which is the count of passes we are done with. And then we are subtracting 1 from I and j because we have started our count from 0. Now I will take an array of 6 elements, and then we will apply each step of algorithm in order to get the clear understanding of it. Since currently we are going to start with first pass, the value of I is equal to 0, and for I equal to 0, the range of inner loop will be from 0 to 5 as we compare each and every adjacent element from starting to end. So first we will compare the value at the index 0 and 1. So here 31 is less than 46, so we don't need to swap it. Now in the second iteration, we will compare 46 and 80. 46 is less than 80, so we don't need to swap it. Then in the third iteration, we will compare 80 and 22. 80 is greater than 22, so we will swap these values. Then in the fourth iteration, we will compare 80 and 68. 80 is greater than 68, so we need to swap it. In the fifth iteration, we will compare 80 and 75. 80 is greater than 75, so we will swap it as well. Now we are done with pass 1, and as you can see, the largest element of the array is placed at the very last index. Now we will start with pass 2, and for pass 2, the value of I will be 1 and the range of j will be from 0 up to 4. And we will repeat the same process as we did in the pass 1, but this time we will do it up to 4th index of the array, so that the largest element in the rest of the array will come at index 4. So 31 is less than 46, so we don't need to swap it. Now 46 is greater than 22, so we will swap it. Then 46 is less than 68, so we don't need to swap it. And then 68 is less than 75, so we will leave it as it is. Now we are done with pass 2. So we will start with the third pass, and in the third pass the value of I will be 2 and the range of inner loop will be from 0 up to 3. So in pass 3 we will compare 31 and 22. 31 is greater than 22, so we will swap it. Then compare 31 and 46. 31 is less than 46, so we don't need to swap it. Then compare 46 and 68. 46 is less than 68, so again we don't need to swap it. So now we are done with pass 3 as well. It's time for pass 4. For pass 4, the value of I will be 3 and the inner loop will go from 0 up to 2. Then compare 22 and 31. It is already sorted, so we don't need to swap it. Then compare 31 and 46. It is sorted as well, so we will leave it as it is. Now we are done with the fourth pass as well. It's time for the final pass. The value of I will be 4 and the range of j will go from 0 up to 1. And as you can see, 22 and 31 is already sorted, so we don't need to do anything. We are done with our outer loop. And as you can see that now our array is sorted in ascending order. Let's calculate the worst case time complexity of this algorithm. As we have already discussed that this inner loop will run for each pass, and after each pass the range of the inner loop is getting decreased by 1. So for the first pass the inner loop will run for n-1 times. Then in the second pass it will run for n-2 times. And similarly in the third pass it will run for n-3 times. And it will continue till 1. And if you have noticed, this expression is in arithmetic progression of nth term. And to solve this, we will simply apply a formula which is n multiplied by n minus 1 over 2. And if you calculate this further, it becomes n square minus n over 2. And since we are going to take the upper bound of it, the time complexity will be the order of n square. In order to implement the bubble sort, first we need an array of some numbers. These numbers either you can take from user or you can generate some random numbers. We are going to take array of random integers, so first we will import the NumPy module. Then we will create an array of 10 random integers between 1 to 100. Before start sorting the array, we will simply print the unsorted array first. And we also need the length of this array for our for loop. So we will store the length of the array in variable n. Then we will create a for loop which will iterate over each pass up to n-1. And inside that we will create another for loop in order to compare the adjacent element of the array. After that we will write an if statement that if the current element is greater than the next element, then we will swap the values. Finally we will print the array. We are done with writing the code. Now let's run it. You can see the result. First array is the array of random numbers we generated and the second array is the array that our program has sorted. And every time you run this code, it will show you different array as every time it is generating different random numbers. That's all for this video, and in the next video of this series, we will discuss about insertion sort.